Can you hold my hands? They're really cold.
The hot desert sun.
On behalf of Allie and Adam, I would like to welcome you all today and thank you for traveling to come and bear witness to the union of Allie and Adam in marriage and as they begin this next chapter of their lives. Stay warm. We're going to get through this together. I'm honored that Allie and Adam asked me to preside over their nuptials today. But I think it's only fitting to share with you my connection to both the bride and the groom. Allie is my first cousin on my mom's side of the family. Despite living on opposite sides of the country, we would often spend extended periods visiting in the summer and sometimes over the holidays. As a kid, I always got excited when my cool cousins and aunt from Nevada would come to visit. We spent summers playing in Oma and Opa's backyard, eating crabs, kicking balls over the fence of the grandparents' neighbors, and staying up all night laughing, playing pranks, and joking. Allie was and is funny, stubborn, athletic, and strong-willed. We always got along, and I don't remember us ever getting into a fight. Allie, I love you, cousin.
I love you.
Even if you did puke on me while I was sleeping that one time when we were kids. And I'm so happy for you that you've met someone who loves and appreciates you as much as I do. And Adam. Adam is a close friend of my husband, Colin. I met Adam for the first time about 6 years ago when I met up with Colin and some of his friends at a street festival for Bastille Day in D.C.
Vive la France.
Upon meeting Adam, I was immediately struck by his positivity and how engaging and full of energy he was. At some point that day, I remember feeling a little left out from the group of boys, but I remember Adam quickly taking notice and trying to make sure I was having fun and felt included. Adam was and is sensitive, kind, animated, and spirited. Okay. So flash forward to the part of the story where Allie and Adam meet. The time is just about 4 years ago, the place, Colin and my wedding, at the fun table.
Yeah.
The fun table had been carefully selected just several weeks earlier to include some of my single friends from college, my cool cousins Lauren and Allie from Nevada, and Adam. Adam arrives to the table kind of flustered and disheveled, and took his seat under an unfortunate overhead light that shone down on him like a spotlight. Adam's arrival caught the attention of the other guests at the table, including Allie, and the ice was broken, the group quickly laughing and joking about the spotlight. In no time, Adam was using his metaphorical and literal spotlight to recruit other fun table members to join the resistance to rise up against Trump. This made an impression on Allie, and the rest is really history. Allie and Adam, I'm so happy that you met at my wedding on that November day 4 years ago, and I'm honored to be here to join the two of you today. On the very day we learned the resistance was triumphant. At this time, I would like to invite Adam's sister Abby to share a reading.
You stay here. Hold me because I'm so cold.
You guys want to just maybe step a little bit so you can. Yeah, just like about a foot. Okay.
Okay. Touched by an Angel by Maya Angelou.
Okay. We unaccustomed to courage, exiles from delight, lived coil in shells of loneliness until love leaves its high holy temple and comes into our sight to liberate us into life. Love arrives, and in its train come ecstasies, old memories of pleasure, ancient histories of pain. Yet if we are bold, love strikes away the chains of fear from our souls. We are weaned from our timidity in the flesh of love's light. We dare be brave, and suddenly we see that love costs all we are and will ever be. Yet it is only love which sets us free.
No, Abby crying is a girl. That is a... Love you.
Holding me.
Keep are you? Holding you?
No, yeah, I'm
good.
Really cold.
I know. Okay. I'm sorry.
And now it is time to share in the vows of marriage. Adam, please answer me this. Do you, Adam, take Allie to be your lawfully wedded wife from this day forward to have and to hold, for better or worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish all of the days of your life?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Allie, please answer me this. Do you, Allie, take Adam to be your lawfully wedded husband from this day forward to have and to hold, for better or worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish all of the days of your life?
Absolutely.
Now Allie and Adam will be reading their vows, which they have written. Adam is going to go first.
Okay. Oh, I'm going first?
Yeah.
Let's do this.
Oh, you have yours. I was like, thank gosh. I was like looking at my sheet, and I was like, it's not here.
Those of you at home, pour a drink right now. All right. I'm just a kid from Southwest Iowa, raised in Central Nebraska. who landed in the nation's capital and who has found a girl from Las Vegas and a Texas Longhorn even.
That's right.
And now I've ended up in the Pacific Northwest to have a wonderful life together. We met at a wedding, and now we have our own.
Aww.
Truly the magical rom-com story. I'm a cat guy that always just liked big dogs. Now every night I walk a little dog named Chip, happily.
Leave it to Chip.
I've spent more time with you this past year than any human possible on the planet. And we are still here today. Victory.
Yay.
Our differences do exist. You want to just watch reality in HDTV constantly. I need multiple screens for sports. You enjoy organizing, and honestly, I really don't care. But our complementary behavior shines on. When you have road rage, I talk you off the edge. When I'm distraught over dumb game, you chill me out. And the values we share are our superpowers. Compassion, empathy, loyalty, the importance of family and friendship, and the tenacity to fight what we think is right. You make me a better person. I vow to protect you and our family, and most importantly, I vow to have your back because I know that you'll always have mine.
Oh, that was really good. Good job. All right, Adam. I would have never believed that the guy at my cousin's wedding, who arrived very last to the singles table, and therefore would have a beam of light piercing directly into his eyes throughout dinner, would become the love of my life. But here we are. I can't say that I will ever truly believe or get how every game, literally every game, is the most important game of the season, especially when it's three different games on three different TVs, or why you care so much about golf. But I can say I love how important each game is to you, and I promise that I will be right there next to you until the end of time, only occasionally asking for an HGTV break. I admire your unwavering passion, your love for life, and the devotion you show to the people in it. I have no clue how I became lucky enough to be your number one, but I promise to never take that for granted. I can feel your love and how you love me. Thank you for loving me, not in spite of my flaws, but because of them. However, we all know they are very limited in number. Today, I promise to continue to love all of you for the rest of my life. And it's the easiest promise I've ever had to make, because I honestly just love you so much. I love to see you happy. I love to show you the same care and consideration. And I love how much you love Chip. And more than anything, I love growing together with you. I love our life and what we are building. And most importantly, I love you.
Sorry. Yeah. Premature. Wow.
Soon.
We're close.
We're
so
close.
We're close.
I promise.
I know. Wow. That was awkward too. What's your name?
Now we will exchange the rings, Jacob, if you could give the rings.
I don't think I've ever dodged your kiss before.
Yeah, that was a good one.
Okay. Thank you.
Is this your left hand?
Okay. Sorry, I need a minute to. Okay. You're going to go first. So you're going to put that on her left hand. All right. Adam, as you place the ring on Allie's finger, please repeat after me. You can, yep. I, Adam, give you Allie this ring.
I, Adam, give you Allie this ring.
As a sign of my vow to love.
As a sign of my vow to love.
Honor and cherish you.
To honor and cherish you.
Allie, as you place this ring on Adam's finger, please repeat after me. I, Allie, give to you, Adam.
I, Allie, give to you, Adam.
This ring as a sign of my vow to love.
This ring is a sign of my vow to love.
Honor and cherish you.
Honor and cherish you.
All right. Okay.
Are we done? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Corey.
Adam and Allie, having witnessed your vows of love and faith to each other, by the power invested in me by the American Marriage Ministries, aka the internet, and the state of Nevada, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Allie, you may now kiss your groom.
Oh, yeah!